Okay, knights on three, family on six, because at the end of the day, we're not just a team, we're a family.
Failing is part of succeeding. If you don't try, you only guarantee that failure is the end of the story.
You need to play every game as if it were your last. Leave it all on the court. No regrets.
It's important to look how far you've grown. Look at where you started and see how much you've improved. The elephant was big enough and strong enough to break away from the rope, but he never thought that he could. You can be first, you can be last, you can be anywhere in between. But as long as you try your best, we will be proud of you.
There's people out there more talented than you and I, but what's going to set us apart is hard work.
Gold and black, on the attack. It's a great day to be a knight. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to an historic event, the first ever virtual St. Pius X Athletic Awards Ceremony, coming to you live from the United Center. I am your host, Mr. Sullivan, and boy, do we have a treat for you tonight. Welcome. I was courtside earlier, but they have kicked me out of the stadium because of the social distancing. I'm actually broadcasting live from the locker room. So thank you all for being here this evening. The biggest night in sports becomes the biggest television in sports. We're going to start things like we always do here at St. Pius X with a prayer. At this time, we'd like to kick it over to Class President L. Bruschuk. Take it away, L.
Hi, everyone. Hope all is doing well and staying safe in quarantine. If you can you please join in with me saying the athlete's prayer? In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen. Lord Jesus, we welcome your presence and your spirit of love alive in the community of St. Pius X School. Today we gather to represent our school. Share with us your spirit of peace and love for one another. Bless us with a team spirit of goodwill, both for ourselves and for our opponents. Help us to be the best we can possibly be, to strive not so much to win as to play fairly and well. Draw us close together as a team and as a group of friends who reflect your spirit of love. We ask this in your name, Lord Jesus. Amen. In the name of Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you and hope you guys have a great day.
Thank you so much, Al. We ask at this time that you please stand, remove your hats, as we honor America with the singing of our national anthem. Since we are broadcasting live from the United Center this evening, we figured we'd bring in the national anthem singer for the Blackhawks. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Jim Corneliuson.
Hello to everybody at St. Pius X Parish School in Lombard, Illinois. This is Jim Corneliuson with the Chicago Blackhawks, and I am here to start off your first ever athletic virtual awards ceremony with the national anthem. So without further ado, please rise, remove your hats, join me as we do our national anthem. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, where so gallantly streamed want to wish the class of 2020 all the best with all their future endeavors. Be safe. Be healthy. Go Knights. God bless.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jim Corneliuson. Before we move on to the next section, we'd like to remind you that we are live on Facebook and YouTube Live. Up next, we're going to do what we always do at our award ceremony. We're going to recognize our championship teams. Cross country this year was the most successful cross country season in school history. And we recognize those champions now. The fifth grade boys SPL cross country division AA champions. Congratulations on your accomplishment. We raise this banner in your honor. Oh, ain't it a beautiful sight? The fifth grade girls SPL cross country division AA champions. We raise this banner in your honor. The sixth grade girls SPL cross country division AA champions. This is actually a back-to-back championship. Congratulations. We raise this banner in your honor. The seventh grade boys SPL cross country division AA champions. They completed the three-peat. Congratulations, gentlemen. We raise this banner in your honor. The seventh grade girls SPL cross country division AA champions. We raise this banner in your honor. The girls not only finished first in division AA, but they finished first in the entire SPL out of 28 schools. And then the eighth grade girls SPL cross country division AA champions. These ladies completed the four-peat. Congratulations, ladies, the first group in St. Pius history to accomplish this feat. We raise this banner in your honor. We'd also like to recognize our SPL cross country overall boys 5th through 8th grade team, which won the Division AA championship for the first time in school history. Congratulations, gentlemen, on your accomplishment. We raise this banner in your honor. The SPL cross country overall girls 5th through 8th grade division AA champions. We raise this banner in your honor. It is a back-to-back championship, and they were the first place girls program in the entire Suburban Parochial League. Congratulations, ladies. We also have our IESA state qualifying team. This year, St. Pius X became a member of the Illinois Elementary School Association. At the sectional meet, the boys took third place, and the girls were runner-ups and took second place. This allowed us to compete at the state meet, where in Class 1A, the St. Pius Knights took 13th place at the girls' level and 20th place at the boys' level. Congratulations. And the championships keep on coming. Fifth grade girls basketball, DPL regular season and tournament champions. We raise this banner in your honor. Congratulations. The sixth grade girls basketball DPL tournament champions. This is actually a back-to-back championship. We raise this banner in your honor. The seventh grade boys basketball DPL regular season and tournament champions. This was actually the first overall championship that we have had in boys basketball since 2004. 16 years. Congratulations, gentlemen, on this accomplishment. Our seventh grade girls basketball DPL regular season and tournament champions. Congratulations, ladies, on this back-to-back championship. We raise this banner in your honor. And finally, last but not least, the eighth grade girls, DPL regular season and tournament champions, who won in spite of their coaches. And they completed the three-peat. We raise this banner in their honor. Congratulations to all of our champions. We're going to announce the fifth grade girls participants after this commercial break.
St. Pius Knights, welcome to the first commercial of our athletic award ceremony. I've been thinking of the perfect time and place to deliver this message to you, and I feel like the first commercial is truly the best. We miss you right now. Your coaches miss you, and I miss you. I wish we could be here right now in this gym. People playing volleyball, playing basketball, the crowd going nuts, Mr. Pollock cooking up a storm in the back. But right now, the best thing we need to do is stay home. I know people want to get in this gym, but it's not the right thing to do. I mean, Mr. Murphy has been pestering me. Phone call, email, text message, Insta-snap, chat-snap. He even sent a carrier pigeon. I didn't even know that they still did that stuff. I miss you kids so much, I can't even hear a basketball being dribbled. This place does have ghosts.
I'll tell you this, you know, I may be in the locker room of the United Center right now, and there may not be anyone here, but I'm telling you, I think St. Pius has ghosts. There's a long story about me leaving once at 11. It doesn't matter. Now's not the time or place. What it is the time and place for, though, is to announce our fifth grade girl student athletes. Now, if we were live in person, we have a tradition at St. Pius where we announce individuals that are four-sport athletes. So it may be Paul Vallott, cross-country, volleyball, basketball, track and field. And then normally me and the audience will go and say at the same time, four-sport athlete. It's a tradition unlike any other. So even though we're not together and even though you're in the comfort of your homes, I ask that when we announce a four-sport athlete that everyone in your household scream four-sport athlete off the top of your lungs. So here we go, introducing the class of 2023. Isabella Anderson, basketball, cross-country, track and field. Zari Bajic, basketball. Maddie Barrett, basketball, cross-country, volleyball. Nasa Bianco, basketball, cross-country, track and field. I hope you're ready at home. Taylor Buis, basketball, cross-country, track and field, and volleyball. Four-sport athlete. Rosie Callahan, basketball, cross-country, track and field, and volleyball. Four-sport athlete. Brooke D'Amico, basketball, cross-country, track and field, and volleyball. Four-sport athlete. Mackenzie Edison, basketball, cross-country, track and field, and volleyball. Four-sport athlete. Maddie Goetz, basketball, cross-country, track and field, and volleyball. Four-sport athlete. Hannah Gravetti, basketball, cross-country, track and field, and volleyball. Four-sport athlete. Aubrey Raffin, basketball. Haley Sproul, cross-country. Bethany Urich, basketball, cross-country, track and field, and volleyball. Four-sport athlete. Please give a round of applause for our fifth grade girl student athletes. We'll announce the fifth grade boys after this commercial break.
Express yourself. Hi, we're going to do this. This is level two, but I'm going to show you how to do how I would start level one. You don't never need help. I mentioned this long line right here. That's called a measure line. All you got to do now. Express yourself. talking about texture.
Do it good.
The man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Paul Vallott. Up next, we're going to recognize the class of 2023, the fifth grade boys. Francis Aresta, cross country, track and field. Andrew Ayala, basketball. Jake Borjo, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Gavin Conway, cross country, track and field. Big Ben Evenson, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Owen Ferris, basketball, cross country, track and field. Michael Garner, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Robert Gutierrez, basketball, track and field. Jack May, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. J.J. Muley, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Joey Neustadt, basketball, cross country, track and field. Johnny Neustadt, basketball, cross country, track and field. Nino Pasola, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Michael Pavoni, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Nicholas Pogorelick, basketball, track and field. Miles Romano, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Joey Serpico, basketball. AJ Tortorello, who does not have a better beard than me. Basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Please give a round of applause for our fifth grade boys. We're going to announce the sixth grade girls after this commercial break.
Please remember.
Please remember.
Please remember.
Please remember.
These are kids.
This is a game.
The coaches are volunteers.
The referees are human.
And this is not the NBA. So kids, stay safe. Stay healthy. Go wash your hands. And go Knights.
Stay safe. Stay healthy. Go Knights.
Stay safe. Stay healthy. And go Knights.
Stay safe. Stay healthy. And go Knights.
Thank you to our IHSA officials. They are an integral part of what we do and how we make great things happen. Remember, referees are human and they're great people too. So thank you to those referees that participated in that commercial. Up next, we have the sixth grade girls, the class of 2022. Akshaya Anem, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Camilla Castrojan, basketball and volleyball. Julia Chacho, cross country, track and field. Allie Coppersmith, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Eva De La Cruz, basketball, cross country, track and field. Emily De Peralta, cross country, track and field. Cameron Fountain, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Savannah Gutierrez, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. London Janish, basketball, and volleyball. Rachel Johnson, basketball, cross country, track and field. Carissa Jones, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Oh, dramatic pause. Wait for it. Wait for it. Four sport athletes. Oh, you guys are really bringing the energy tonight. I like what I'm seeing. Ashlyn Lint, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete, Jolie Maciejewski, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete, Nicole Navarro, basketball and volleyball. Eleanor Neal, basketball, cross country, track and field. Ava Neustadt, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Juliana Neustadt, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Kathleen Nevels, what time is it? It's time for Kathleen to be announced. Basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Mackenzie Racine, track and field, and volleyball. Ellie Rocknich, track and field, and volleyball. Jessica Sigzon, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Audrey Spada, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Allie Stefani, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Grace Tritina, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Alyssa Wiemerslag, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Lauren Wiemerslag, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Please give a round of applause for our sixth grade girls participants. We'll announce the sixth grade boys after this commercial break.
During the quarantine, not having any sporting events, we felt it was essential to still keep providing a high quality product. So we've decided to take our world famous concession stand and go on DoorDash, Uber Eats, Grubhub as a way to still bring income in for the school.
Mr. Pollock, what up, big dog?
Hey, Mr. Sullivan, how you doing today?
I'm great. Hey, where are you at? We're opening up Grubhub, Uber Eats, DoorDash. Where are you?
I told you I had to work today. You're all on your own, Sully.
Well, since my right-hand man, Mr. Pollock, is working, I couldn't do this all by myself. So I need to call in my left-hand man, a person that dedicates so much time and effort to this school, that whose presence is just unparalleled. The man who puts the boom boom into your heart. Nighty night. Yeah, buddy.
Thank you for your order. Nighty night, we need some popcorn. Nighty night, oh no. No, nighty night, it's in a bag, the little yellow kernels. No, that's not popcorn, oh my God. Will that complete your order? Oh, thank you very much. Nighty night, cotton candy. Oh, what, no, it's in a plastic bin, it's fake. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. Nighty night! Another setback order of mozzarella sticks! This is the fifth one! We're losing money! Yes! 2 minutes and 10 seconds! You put it in, you take it out! Oh, not 21 minutes! Oh, 99! Oh!
Okay, so Nighty Night is taking things more literal than I thought he would. And maybe we've burnt through half of our product. I mean, it's not my fault that the fire department came here last week. How was I supposed to know that Nighty Night was gonna set the kitchen on fire? I know this looks like a mess. Okay, but if there's one positive that comes out of it, is that it's bringing a sense of normalcy. I'm seeing people walk through the door just like we do when we have Knights Athletics.
Sir, can I help you?
Hey, my wife already paid me.
But sir, there's no games here. The stay-at-home order.
Thank you for shopping here today with us, miss. That'll be $3.
Oh, I only have 100. Is that okay?
Well, maybe the interaction with people wasn't as great as I thought it was. But we're trying here. And we're being innovative. We are trying some new things. Are you ready for it? Ice cream to go. It is going to be the biggest thing since sliced bread.
One ice cream to go? I got it for you. Just wait right there. I got to go get it from the freezer. Where is it? Where is it?
99! There's no ice cream! Where's the hot fudge? The whipped cream, the cherries! I sent you to Jewel! Where is it? No, 99! No! That's not what I meant!
We've tried Sundays before, and it's a sticky situation. I mean, it falls on the floor and it leaves a mess. Miss McGinn gets upset at me, so Mr. Pollock had to take it off the menu. Yeah, and Nighty Knight, you know, world's greatest mascot, world's worst concession stand worker. But we still love him anyways. Back to the ceremony. Up next, the sixth grade boys, the class of 2022. Here we go. Ryan Alsobrook. Basketball, cross country, track and field. Casey Biederman, basketball, track and field. Ethan Blachek, basketball, cross country, volleyball. Jackson Buis, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Chris Davis, track and field. Alex Dew, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Noah Edison, basketball, cross country, track and field. Jack Goodhart, volleyball. Johnny Gossmeyer, basketball, cross country, volleyball. Finnegan Grimes, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Ali Janjua, basketball, track and field. Jay Newman, basketball, track and field. Aiden Ortega, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Charlie Pasiga, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Bryce Ryan, basketball. Max Voss, basketball. Please give a round of applause for our sixth grade boys participants. We'll come back and announce the seventh grade girls after these commercial breaks.
Why is everything chrome?
Cash. Man, this beat got me feeling like the French time boys in this beat. Lean with it, rock with it, lean, sweat, rock.
Do not forget to purchase your Knights athletic apparel at sign-up time. The largest cross-country program in the Joliet Diocese. We hope you'll give it a try this fall. The KCAA Sports Network presents the St. Pius X Athletic Award Ceremony, coming to you live from the United Center. Brought to you by our proud sponsors. Skipco Painting. Craig Neville's Web and Print Design. www.savecraig.com. And Adored Salon. You are looking live at Feed My Starving Children. We do it at the beginning at every cross-country season. Service learning is an instrumental part of our athletic program. Look at all those smiling faces. You can be a part of that. Make sure you join cross-country this upcoming fall. Truly, an amazing event. Thank you to everyone that participates in our Feed My Starving Children event. If you've never done it before, I highly recommend it. Up next, we have the seventh grade girls, the class of 2021. Haley Ahrens, basketball. Mickey Alandi, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Haley Andretti, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Eva Oxt, basketball, track and field. Lauren Berger, cross country, track and field. Therese Batano, basketball and volleyball. Olivia Bernardi, track and field. Molly Brown, basketball, cross country, track and field. Addie Callahan, cross country. Jeannie Casey, cross country, track and field. Mia D'Amico, basketball, cross country, track and field. Annalie DeFeo, basketball and cross country. Paige Denke, basketball. Izzy Evenson, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Sophia Fountain, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Julia Gergen, basketball, cross country, track and field. Nina Guajardo, volleyball. Delilah Highland, volleyball. Gabriella Janis, volleyball. Jamie Loftus, track and field and volleyball. Kaylee Marshall, volleyball. Jordan Mogolinski, basketball, cross country, track and field and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Olivia Pollock, track and field and volleyball. Raging Red Wendy Pollock, track and field and volleyball. Agnes Rueka, track and field. Liz Tratina, basketball and volleyball. Olivia Weiland, basketball, track and field and volleyball. Please give a round of applause for our seventh grade girls student athletes. We will announce the seventh grade boys after this commercial break.
What time is it? It's nighttime.
Be like. sight seeing.
Congratulations to our basketball champions. What an inspirational commercial. I want to be like Mike Pollock, that is. Greatest concession stand coordinator in the county, in the state, in the nation, in the world. Up next, we move to our seventh grade boys, the class of 2021. Kyle Andretti. Basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Carl Aresta, cross country and track and field. Jack Barrett, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Kason Blaine, basketball, cross country, track and field. Luke Barho, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Austin Coppersmith, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Wait for it. You can build the tension. Four sport athlete. Hey, you guys didn't wait for me. We got to do that again. Four sport athlete. Thank you. Will Cross, basketball and volleyball. Henry Dawson, basketball. Eddie Devins, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Nolan Ferris, aka coach, basketball, cross country, track and field. Lou Hassler, basketball and volleyball. Lucas Iwanski, basketball. Jimmy Lint, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Nicholas Malab, basketball. Juan Navarro, basketball. Maxwell Neal, basketball, cross country, track and field. Jason Nelson, basketball. Sean Presley, basketball. Adriano Quintero, basketball and track and field. Dean Romano, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Ariash Sampat, basketball and volleyball. Shendizel Hank Shendel, basketball, track and field, and volleyball. Jake Skibby, basketball, cross country, and volleyball. Paul Southern, basketball, cross country, track and field. Tommy Wickstrom, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Peter Williams, the editor in chief of the KCA Sports Network, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Jonathan Yaruso, basketball, cross country, track and field. Let's give a round of applause for our seventh grade boys student athletes. We will honor our retiring coaches after this commercial break.
A very important question.
Wow. There's one thing that we can do here at St. Pius X. It's tell time. And you know what time it is? It's nighttime. Hey, what are you yelling at? You know, Betty the Bull's giving me the business over here. Hey, it's our house tonight. It's our house tonight. I'm telling you, these mascots are just, they're killing me. I mean, I just can't win with these mascots, I'm telling you. Well, with every group of retiring and graduating student athletes, there's also a group of retiring coaches. Will the following individuals please come on to the virtual stage? Kevin Obrukta, Ed Castaneda, Josh Bruschuk, and Aaron Bruschuk. Today, these individuals received a plaque that stated, a special thanks to Kevin Obrukta, Ed Castaneda, Josh Bruschuk, and Aaron Bruschuk, an appreciation for all 4 years of service and more dedicated to the St. Pius X Athletic Association. With your continued support, you have helped keep all the programs a success. So let's meet these individuals. Kevin Obrukta has been a basketball coach for us for the past 8 years. He started off as an assistant coach and eventually made his way up to the head coaching ranks. Kevin was best known for his knowledge and technical breakdown of the sport. The thing I admire most about Kevin was that he was consistently advocating for his athletes. He wanted nothing but the best for them. Thank you, Kevin, for your 8 years of service. Up next, we have Coach Lieutenant Colonel Ed IMAX Castaneda, also a basketball coach for us for the past 8 years. He started off as an assistant coach and eventually made his way up to the head coaching ranks. Ed was instrumental in our Hoops for the Troops service learning event. He would spend close to 10 hours in the gym just to ensure that everyone realized the important and sentimental meaning that a care package from the troops meant. For those that don't know, Ed is a pilot, and he would purposely shift his flight schedule to ensure that he made practices. Most importantly, he instilled discipline, hard work, and structure in our student athletes' routine. Thank you so much, Ed. And then there's this guy. I'll tell you this. I'm gonna go on the screen for this one. I've been the athletic director here for 9 years, okay? And if you were to ask me what's been the most challenging thing in 9 years, it's getting Josh Bruschuk to take a serious photo. I tried for this. No, that didn't work. Not sure what was wrong with that bag of Doritos, but he's giving me the thumbs down. Now, this one's my favorite, actually. That's a good look, Josh. I think you should keep it. Yeah, and when the photos didn't work, I said, you know what? Let's try having him send in a video. I mean, he can't possibly mess that up.
Mr. Sullivan, turn up the music. I can't hear the videos. My right ear and my left. There's so many championships that the girls have won. I can't hear it. Turn it up.
I just don't know. I try. Thankfully, with the help of his wife, there's a nice picture. I've been the athletic director here for 9 years, and Josh has been an assistant basketball coach in our program for 6 of them. What I admire most about Josh is that his actions always set the best example for our student athletes. As an assistant coach, he was supportive, motivational, and a team player. He knew what his role was, and he owned it. Josh has this magnificent gift of being able to pull an athlete to the side who may be struggling, frustrated, sad, angry, or upset, and he's able to turn their mindset around by instilling the positivity and confidence that that athlete needs. And I got to give him credit. You know, when you put up with Murphy, Vittorio, and Gravetti, that's no easy task. I mean, you know, I give him credit for that. Josh, thank you for everything. And that last but not least, Aaron Bruschuk. Now, Aaron has a very special place in my heart. She's been a volleyball coach here in our program for the past 6 years. She provides a calming presence, yet knows how to get her athletes fired up. She encouraged and pushed her athletes to be the best that they can be. In addition to coaching, Erin has been a long-standing member of our athletic board. She has been instrumental in the success of all of our major events. And I think she holds the record for the most times having decorated the gym for an important event. Whether it's putting together baskets for Volley for the Cure or organizing the 8th grade blackout, she actually put together a blackout Bible to ensure that all future St. Pius student athletes got the same phenomenal experience that her daughters received. And Erin is a big Bon Jovi fan. Erin, shot through the heart and you're to blame, but you give love a bad name. But that is a strong love that can be cured with bad medicine, which your love is also like. In all seriousness, though, Erin has always looked out for me. She's treated me like a son. She's always checked out on me to see if there was anything she could do to help. If she was part of the cleanup crew, she would not leave me until everything was done. I could not even tell you the number of hours that we've been in this gym until midnight. She's truly irreplaceable. You're simply the best, Erin. To Ed, Josh, Kevin, and Erin, thank you so much for touching the lives of our student athletes over the years. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment we have all been waiting for. It is time to honor and recognize our 8th grade student athletes. Without a doubt, this class contained a lot of extremely talented individuals. What makes you guys a very unique class is that you not only excelled in athletics, but you also excelled in theater, band, dancing, singing, and so much more. My challenge to you is that when you enter high school in the next few months, participate in the extracurricular activities that will inspire you, motivate you, and make you happy. Strive for the greatest, because you can accomplish anything you put your mind to. So you're probably wondering, what do the 8th graders receive? Well, I did have a video I was trying to play here, but you know, trying to upload something to the Google Drive from the locker room of the United Center is difficult. So we'll send that on social media later. But shout out to athletic board members Jory Maciejewski, Emily Coppersmith, Stacy Pollock, Jenny Evenson, Craig Nevels, and Ben May for delivering VIP bags for our 8th graders this afternoon in preparation for this evening's ceremony. They received a plaque that represents the sports they participated in, a baton if you were in 8th grade track, a list of what you should expect now that you've become a high school athlete, some popcorn, sunglasses, and a few other special surprises, and the St. Pius X letter. Similar to a high school varsity letter, this letter, which is an enlargement of the St. Pius X logo, has the following message to the student athletes. In celebration of your athletic career at St. Pius X, please accept this varsity letter in sports pins in recognition of your hard work and commitment. You are receiving a pin for any sport you participated in over the past 4 years of eligibility. In addition, pins are included to represent your contribution to one or more of these school championship teams, or if you are a member of the IESA state finals team. Great job and go Knights. Here we go. The 8th grade girls. The class of 2020. Here we go. L. Bruschuk. Basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Katie Carney, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Alisa Chavillo, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athletes. Ani Espinoza, basketball and volleyball. Marin Ferris, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Haley Getz, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Jasmine Gonzaga, volleyball. Leia Gravetti, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Ariel Hoda, basketball, and cross country. Aaron McShane, cross country and track and field. Nicole Navis, volleyball. Izzy Ortega, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Carrie Ostrowski, basketball and volleyball. Meg Schaub, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Alea Turner, basketball and volleyball. Riley Wilk, basketball, cross country, and volleyball. Please give a round of applause for the ladies of the class of 2020. The KCA Sports Network presents the Knights Athletic Association Awards, brought to you by Wickstrom Chevrolet. All Together Transportation. High House 6 Photography. And U.S. Safety Products Graphics and Apparel. You are looking live at two of our biggest service learning events, Volley for the Cure and Hoops for the Truth. This year for Volley for the Cure, we raised over $9,000 for the Polycarp Research Institute. And for Hoops for the Troops, we donated over 24 bins of product to Operation Care Package. Thank you to everyone that supports our service learning initiatives. And now back to the class of 2020. The gentlemen of the class of 2020. Gabriel Bianco, basketball, cross country, track and field. Josh Blachek, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Mr. Eighth Grade Blackout, Eddie Castaneda, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Nick Deno, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Julian De Peralta, basketball and volleyball. Austin Gaspar, basketball. David Gonzalez, basketball and volleyball. Hadi Janjua, basketball and track and field. Sean Obrata, basketball and volleyball. Joey Rosenthal, basketball, cross country, track and field, and volleyball. Four sport athlete. Carson Stefani, basketball and track and field. The Greek Freak, Dimitri Verlos, basketball, cross country, track and field. Please give a round of applause for the gentlemen of the class of 2020. Up next, we have the biggest award that we offer at this school, the 4x4 award. And for an award so special, you have to have a musical introduction. Coming to you from Comiskey Park, give it up for the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Paul Vallott.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the award show musical interlude. I will be performing a piece on my saxophone. This is a tenor saxophone. An alto has kind of a straighter crook right here. But anyway, this is a piece by lesser-known composer John Tesh. So please enjoy. The Award show, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Paul Vallott. So now, the time has come. The most prestigious award that we give as part of this athletic association, the St. Pius X 4x4 Award. It's an award presented to student athletes at the end of their eighth grade year who have participated in all four sports offered: cross-country, volleyball, basketball, and track and field for all 4 years of athletic eligibility. The class of 2020 is so special that it has a record number of recipients, 6. And we are going to meet them now. Our first recipient, Miss L. Bruschuk. Congratulations, L. Mr. 8th Grade Blackout, Eddie Castaneda. Congratulations, bud. Very proud. Elisa Chavillo. And Elisa, is her grandfather, one of our former track coaches, Coach Nolden, actually had a banner put up today. Congratulations to our four-sport, four-year athlete. Congratulations, Elisa. Miss Haley Getz. Congratulations, Haley. Leia Gravetti. Congratulations, Leia. And last but certainly not least, Meg Schaub. Now, this is the 5th year that we presented this award. The 5th year. These 6 individuals tonight become a part of history. And we start a new tradition that I'm very happy to share with you. This plaque will now hang in the hallway in St. Pius X, recognizing our 4x4 award recipients. So, tonight, we welcome Elle, Eddie, Elisa, Haley, Leia, and Meg into exclusive company with Elizabeth Gravetti, Ellie King, Dan Beta, Gabby Castaneda, Mr. Fifth Quarter Jack Cullerton, T-Money Tyler King, Michael Poyer, Abby Spada, Devin Cullerton, Joey Pearson, Sarah Gravetti, Sophie Sullivan, Allie Vittorio, Chris Beta, and Sean Maciejewski. Congratulations on this wonderful accomplishment. And for those of you athletes that may be 4th grade or younger, or those of you in 5th, 6th, or 7th grade, if you're on path to becoming a 4x4 athlete, it's an opportunity for you to hang in the hall of St. Pius forever. And now we move on to the coaches' speeches. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now, you didn't think I wouldn't have a special guest, did you? Now, ladies and gentlemen, this special guest is actually an alumni of St. Joan of Arc School in Lisle, Illinois. He's a former member of Bennett Academy's basketball team. He led the University of Wisconsin-Madison to a runner-up finish in the NCAA tournament. He is currently a member of the NBA's Phoenix Suns. Please give it up for your guest speaker to speak to the class of 2020, the NBA's very own Mr. Frank Kaminsky.
What's going on, everyone? Frank Kaminsky of the Phoenix Suns here. I just want to give a quick shout out to the St. Pius X 8th grade class of 2020 and thank you all for what you've done for the DuPage Parochial League over the years. It wasn't too long ago that I was sitting in your shoes as an aspiring DPL athlete in the Chicago suburbs about to embark on my high school journey. My path was by no means an easy one, and I had many hurdles along the way. The next level to high school is a tough jump for everyone, and I was no exception to this. But I always kept my dreams and goals front and center in everything I did. I paid my dues. I worked hard every single day, and this paid off in the end. So put in the extra time. Go get shots up, hit the weight room, do extra cardio, and become an overall better athlete as you transition to the next level. The biggest message I want to leave you all with is whenever you get knocked down, on the court, in the classroom, at work, or in life, get back up and keep fighting. I've had to overcome so many obstacles in my career, and there are a lot of people out there who didn't expect me or want me to ever overcome them. But every time I've gotten back on my feet and kept pushing forward. Use your dreams to help you get through any hardships you encounter, and you'll find your own success in life, however you define it. Thank you all, stay safe, and enjoy the rest of your eighth grade days.
Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of applause for Mr. Frank the Tank Kaminsky. Thank you so much, Frank, for being a part of this ceremony. And now for this commercial break. The KCAA Sports Network presents the St. Pius X Knights Athletic Award Ceremony, coming to you live from the Madhouse on Madison, the United Center. This is a live look at one of our most valued events, our Athletic Mass, where we come together as a family, coaches, athletes, parents, siblings, to celebrate the Mass. If you've never been to an Athletic Mass, we highly encourage it. It's a spiritual experience unlike any other. It truly is a phenomenal event. So we hope if you've never been to our Athletic Masses, we hope you will consider. Plus, you get donuts and juice afterwards. You can't beat that. So now it is time for our coaches' speeches. Normally, the coaches would send me a script at the Athletic Awards ceremony, and I would read it. But, you know, the thing is, me reading off a piece of paper isn't the same as you hearing it from a coach. And the beautiful thing of this virtual ceremony is that you actually get to listen to your coaches speak to you. So, first up, the eighth grade cross-country coach. Give it up for Mr. Teddy Sullivan.
Hello, class of 2020. Over the past 3 years, I have been blessed to coach each one of you. We have a lot of memories, and while it is sad that these memories are behind us, it is much more special that we can look back at these memories fondly.
Together we have grown, learned about ourselves, and others, work together, experienced success, and had some fun. When you enter the next stage of your life, I hope you'll remember that you have worth, whether you win or lose. You have unique gifts, both discovered and hidden. Do what you enjoy. Your thoughts have a huge impact on your life. Achieving your goals requires going out of your comfort zone. Give back when you can. Let your goofy side free. Thank you for letting me be your coach. Good luck on the next stage of your life's journey. Just because we'll be in different places does not mean that we'll no longer be a team.
Thank you to Coach Teddy for that wonderful speech. Up next, the 8th grade boys head volleyball coach. Give it up for Mrs. Cheryl Walsh.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Walsh, and I get to introduce the 8th grade boys volleyball team. In July at our coaches meeting, Mr. Sullivan was really excited to be able to say that there was enough 8th grade boys for them to field their own team, but there wasn't a coach. For me, there wasn't a hesitation to say we, Mrs. Igo and I, would step up and coach for the 8th grade boys. My thoughts of Eddie, Sean, and Nick playing since 5th grade and learning the basics from Mrs. Mack, and David, Joey, and Joshua coming to join the team for this 8th grade season. So along with Mrs. Zazowski, Mrs. Igo, and I came together to coach for them. We're happy to have the time we spent with the boys and giving them an uplifting season. Bringing the boys together for those who have played for 3 years and those who hadn't played competitive volleyball, we hopefully taught them on how to work for something. Whether it was getting that serve over, finishing the block, setting the perfect ball, getting a massive hit, and winning that point. But most of all, playing together as a team. We hope that each of you, Eddie, David, Joey, Joshua, Nick, and Sean, enjoyed your year of volleyball. Take something away from the season and our team for the future that you have ahead of you. You may not play competitive volleyball again, but know that you've learned a great value of lessons by doing sports here at St. Pius X. We do hope that when springtime comes around and boys volleyball tryouts, that if you're not already dedicated to something, that you will try out for volleyball and see where it takes you. You will step into high school with a solid foundation that was built here at St. Pius. Remember, keep a positive attitude, challenge yourselves, get involved, play a sport, join theater, play a musical instrument, or join a club. Good luck, Eddie, David, Joey, Joshua, Nick, and Sean. And thanks for making it a great volleyball season for us. Love to you from Mrs. Lazowski, Mrs. Igo, and Mrs. Walsh. Thanks, and see you soon.
Thank you, Coach Walsh, for that magnificent speech. Up next, the 8th grade girls volleyball coaches, Kathy Batten, Aaron Bruschuk, and Jill Getz.
Hello, everybody. First, we'd like to thank our parents, our fans, and our dedicated athletic director, Ed Sullivan, for your support over the years. You have all been amazing. And most importantly, we want to say thank you to all the girls we have been blessed to coach over the last 4 years. Watching you grow as athletes has been incredible. Thinking about that first time playing volleyball when it was all about figuring out where the ball was going to go and what you were supposed to do when you got there, and then even thinking about getting that first serve over. Some of you thought it would never happen, but of course it did. We have seen you grow to play some pretty amazing volleyball this past year. A highlight for both teams was taking down St. Mary's of Plainfield on our home court. The girls have brought us much joy and excitement during the time spent with them, both at practices and games and tournaments. This group of girls always came ready to work hard and play hard. Each and every girl brought her own unique personality and spirit, which helped contribute to the team's overall success. Between DPL and DPLW, these girls have brought home several championships over the last few years. Whether it was your first time playing volleyball or you were a club volleyball player, you all supported each other every step of the way. We couldn't ask for anything more than that.
But let's remember the fun too. I can't help but mention candy, music, and dancing as the essential components of a successful timeout. Throughout the years, we came to realize you needed something during timeouts. A little sugar pick-me-up. We went through a few different candies that were not too messy and could be eaten quickly during the timeout. Skittles became the timeout pick of choice. I will never be able to look at a bag of Skittles without thinking of you all. In eighth grade, it turned to sour Skittles. How you could eat that during a timeout and go back to the court, I will never know. Skittles were not the only thing happening during timeouts. You all danced and sang every single timeout. It got to the point that we had to bring music for our away games. We always had Mr. Sullivan at the ready at home, but on the road, it became a necessity to play our phones over a handheld speaker. We did our best, but can't quite live up to Mr. Sullivan's DJing skills. The parents, the other teams, the refs, everyone was always amused by your dancing timeouts. There were times we would actually try and be serious and coach during the timeouts, but typically you weren't having it. Instead, singing at the top of your lungs or laughing. It was just all you doing your thing, and we knew we had to get out of the way. We would just shake our heads and laugh and get you back on the court. I've never seen a group of girls who are so uber competitive but could just have a great time on the court. You rarely took it too seriously. I hope that enjoyment of the moment is something that you take with you into high school. Don't take anything too seriously. Enjoy like you did on the volleyball court with us.
Ladies, it's been an honor and a pleasure to be part of this group the past few years. You have all grown so much in volleyball, teamwork, and friendship. I know you are all going to go forward and do amazing things. I cannot wait to watch it all unfold. I'll leave you with this. You do you. Whatever that may be, you do you.
It has been our pleasure to witness how the girls have all improved on their volleyball skills, but also to see what great girls they have become. They are a thoughtful, funny, caring, and kind-hearted group of girls, and it has been a privilege to coach you over the last 4 years. You make your coaches and parents extremely proud. We know you will all do great next year. Be brave, be kind, and keep playing hard, ladies.
I hope you can take the lessons of Skittles and dancing with you. Try hard, and don't be afraid to make mistakes. There will always be something to pick you up. I wish you all the best as you go on to high school. Have fun, make new friends, and pack Skittles in your lunch. Take care, everybody.
Thank you, Coach Batten, Coach Brushuck, and Coach Getz. Up next, the eighth grade boys basketball coaches. Lieutenant Colonel Ed IMAX Castaneda, Kevin Obrecta, and Tino Stefani.
Hey guys and gals, to the class of St. Pius 2020, on behalf of all the coaches, I want to congratulate you on an awesome 8 years and especially the last 4 years of sports. Unusual times that we're living in right now, but as it is in life and as you guys will find out that nothing in life really goes as far as how you think it's going to go. All you have to do is kind of have to kind of adjust, make the most of it, be grateful, be happy. Not really think of the past because the past does nothing for you, but just try to look ahead and look towards the future, no matter what your endeavors are going to take you. It was amazing, guys, how we all grew over the last 4 years of sports. We started off with like maybe six of you guys joining the team. And then by the eighth grade year, we had all of you guys. It says a lot to who you guys are as people, who you guys are as friends, and especially who you guys are as a team to see that all you guys joined us to play basketball, which was the only sport really out of St. Pius that you saw all the boys play together during the season. One of the things that I kind of want to have you guys take away is not necessarily basketball, but I mentioned every once in a while, so did the coaches mention, some of those life lessons that we kind of saw during sports. One of the biggest first ones kind of that I harped on you guys is paying that attention to detail. I harped on footwork, I harped on movement, I harped on the special details that make a difference. And that's just not towards basketball. You're going to see that no matter where you take it in life, in your job, in your family, that attention to detail really, really kind of is important. Hard work is important, guys. Nothing is going to happen easy in this life, and nothing is going to be without hard work. And the second you realize that it's going to take hard work to succeed and to get ahead in life, you guys are going to go way beyond your wildest dreams. One of the things that I also kind of mentioned was being a team on and off the court. It's like no matter if you're in class or you're in the playground or no matter where you are, your team's your team. Your brothers are your brothers. And I loved how you guys stuck up for each other and supported each other. No matter if it's a pat on the back or a good word or a good job, you guys always did an outstanding job. And by far the last point that I'll make, the thing that made me so proud of you guys for the last 4 years was that no matter if it was practice, no matter if it was a game, you guys never gave up on us. You guys pushed it all the way to the end. You pushed it all the way to practice. You gave your all on all the ladders, and especially during the games, no matter what the score was, if we were up, down, or sideways, you guys played hard all the way to the last minute, and I never needed to, the coaches never needed to say that. That says a lot for your character. It says a lot for what you got inside in your heart, and it says a lot for who you are as a person. So it was a pleasure coaching you guys. I hope you guys do great things in life. I will always remember these last 4 years, believe me, because it was special, especially having our sons and having their friends on the team. So on behalf of me and my family, good luck and God bless you. Coach Kevin.
Thanks, Ed. I'll be very brief. It's been a genuine pleasure coaching all you boys the past 4 years. You're really a great group of young men, and you're going to be doing great things. I just want to say, for your next steps throughout life, work hard at what you enjoy, what you need to do, and be kind, and you will be amazing. Good luck with everything, and take care.
To the class of St. Pius 2020, Gabriel, Eddie, Sean, Joey, Dimitri, Josh, David, Carson, Hadi, Julian, Austin, and Nick, it's been an absolute pleasure. You guys are truly going to be awesome as you go on in life. Thank you for all your hard work.
So on behalf of all the coaches, we want to wish you good luck. Farewell. You guys will always know where to find us. And do good in life. Do hard work. Be good. And good luck. We love you guys.
Take care, guys.
That was Coach Castaneda, Coach Obrachta, and Coach Stefani. Our next speaker is a very important speaker. He is known as, well, he's shorter than Liz Tratina. We know that. He is a lover of nachos and hot dogs with ketchup. He loves the hot dogs with ketchup. And he's not the number one fan of George Michael. That's right. He's actually the president of the fan club. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome. Actually, and one thing I forgot to mention, he actually started this podcast with this really handsome gentleman. It's Murfin something. Well, you should check it out. Nevertheless, please welcome the man that puts the boom boom into your heart, Mr. Dan Murphy.
Girls, you know the hardest part about doing this is knowing that when I finish, it'll be the last time I address you as pious athletes. I'll always smile, though, when thinking of pajama practices, Jamba Juice, post-game meals with your families, and even the whining when the ladders came. The goofiness, the loud music, making fun of your coaches, cart races, dunking practice, and so much more. Know that you are examples to all of us and the world that is ahead of you. Izzy, you stepped out of your comfort zone to play with us this year, always with a smile, getting better each week. Keep pushing in that direction, in your direction down the road. Meg, you remind us that sometimes you need to demand what you want, as the 9 t-shirts in my closet from the St. Jude tournament attest to. Insisting that no one gets them unless they were on that team and earned it. Haley, you remind us not to take things too seriously, whether imitating me on the bench or other forms of silliness. maybe harassing Coach Murphy just a little bit. It reminds me all too often of my own daughters. Ariel, you remind us to stop playing games like wiffle ball and get to work. If you ever need help pursuing your basketball career, we're here. And I love to work with kids who want to work as hard as you do. Alisa, you remind us that inside every grade school girl is the heart and the spirit of a rapper. Marin, you remind us of the sheer force of will and determination, including wanting to run around the school during practice once in a snowstorm. I am sorry I didn't let you though. Leia, you remind us to always be kind and friend and a friend to teammates and to others. And thanks for entertaining me all these years with the Pius gossip. Ani, you remind us to focus on what you do well and to enjoy it. You did manage to shoot a little bit despite Mr. Vittorio's coaching, but when we needed someone to stop or shut down another opponent, we called on you and you relish the challenge. Kerio, you remind us all of the inner coach you are, always ready to go to battle with and for your teammates and us. The only area you were never ready to battle was tying your shoes, but I was happy to help. L, you remind us of the sheer joy of playing sports and competing to better yourself. Of your many talents, this is your greatest one. Alea, you remind us to forget the pressure of the game, to play relaxed and with a smile, including throwing up some pretty crazy shots. Riley, you remind us to smile and to laugh, as you did every single time we did the contact layup drill. And finally, Katie, you remind us to show your emotions. Early on, it looked like you might kill an opponent or two, but you somehow seemed to channel that into becoming great. And with the emotion of the season and the career at an end, know that it's okay to cry. I know. Just a few thoughts as you depart. Girls, step out of your comfort zone. It can be scary, but makes you better. Work hard for what you deserve, then don't be afraid to voice it. Don't take yourself too seriously and show kindness to others. It makes you both better. Coach yourself and others. You never know how much impact you can have on the world. Smile, laugh, and enthusiastically approach life. It opens your heart to great possibility and achievement. Finally, be a shoulder to cry on, and I pray you will all have many others to trust and rely on others, on you and others as well. We coaches have tried to give you our best to help you and in and through your Pius career and this chapter in your lives. Take the best of what we've done and run with it. You have and you will continue to make us proud. Or you will hear a voice in the distance shouting, "Run a ladder!" with the whistle. Although I don't get to pay for your college, I do consider you all my third through 15th daughters. I know you will make us and Pius proud. I love you, girls. God bless you on the journey ahead.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dan Murphy. Well said, Murph. Our last coach's speech comes to you from Mrs. Roseanne Devins, track and field coach.
Hello, track and field, class of 2020. This is Coach Devins coming at you from my backyard. Coach Bianco and I were really excited to get reacquainted with you guys this year. And all of us coaches, Coach Ted, Coach Ed, Coach John, want to wish you guys the best. But I also want to address the elephant in the room. Not Coach Ted's awesome elephant, but the elephant that is COVID-19. It really stinks. And I know a lot of coaches are going to talk to you today about how proud they are of you guys. I've been proud of you since fifth grade. Can't believe how far you guys have grown as individuals, not just as athletes. And I also want to remind you, as we've always talked, that you guys are a team. And as a team, I look at you as a machine. And each part is important. And each part of this machine create something bigger and better than itself. And that's what you guys are doing by sacrificing everything that you're sacrificing today. You know, people like Eddie Castaneda's dad volunteer and make sacrifices every day, but there has not been a generation like yours in a long time that's been asked to sacrifice in every household everywhere in America. And just like our machine, you might think staying home is something small, but you're really a bigger part, and you're doing a thing bigger than yourself. So thank you for bringing your individual talents together to create remarkable moments in the hallways of St. Pius, in your communities, on the court, and in the field. You're going to continue to do that in the future. Good luck.
Thank you, Coach Devins, for that magnificent speech. Now, we present a commercial break. We hope you enjoy it.
We decided that we were going to start our own CD, music provided by coaches. Now that's what I call Nighttime, Volume 1. Oh, wait 1 second. Now, Mr. Sullivan cannot continue doing this commercial, so I've called in DJ Sully. Yeah, you got it. Everyone knows that a DJ Sully party is the best type of party. Our first hit comes to you from the man that puts the boom boom into your heart. Give it up for Coach Murphy.
You put the boom boom into my heart. You set my soul sky high when the loving starts. Jitterbug into my brain, yeah, yeah. Got the bang, bang, bang to my feet to the set.
Or check out this hit by Coach Stefani, reminding you that it's okay to live a crazy life.
Living la vida loca. Living la vida loca. Come on. Living la vida loca. Come on.
Or check out these classic hits by Coach Dew and Coach Newstadt.
I'm going to take my horse to the old town road. I'm going to ride till I can't no more. Going to take my horse to the old town road. I'm going to ride.
Our next song comes from someone whose rapping is just as great as his statistics. Give it up for Coach Geruso.
Oh, basketball is my favorite sport. I like the way they dribble up and down the court. Just like I am the king of the microphone, so is Dr. J. M. Moses Malone. I like slam dunks that take you to the hoop. My favorite play is the alley-oop. I like the pick and roll. I like the give and go. It's just a basketball.
Or enjoy this inspirational rendition of Queen by Coach Maciejewski. Or get ready to fly like you'd never flown before with Coach Borjo.
We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, because we are the champions of the DPS.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly.
You can't have it. Now that's what I call Nighttime CD without everyone's favorite coach. Give it up for Coach Nolan.
Standing after all this time. Picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Woo! This next hit by Coach D'Amico is so famous, it's hit all-star status. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid. And all that glitter is gone. Only shooting stars. This next song is an emotional one. It'll bring tears to your eyes. Give it up for Coach Devins.
These aren't tears of sadness because you're leaving me. I've just been cutting onions. I'm making a lasagna for one.
And you can't forget about our number one hit. You've got the quarantine blues? Well, no worry. Shake it off with Coach Souther.
As the players gonna play, 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 play. Haters gonna hate, 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 hate. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake it off, shake it off.
What are you waiting for? Bust out your tablet, take out your phone, pull up your laptop, and order That's What I Call Nighttime Volume 1. Sold for limited time. Sponsored by the Knights Athletic Association. What time is it? Nighttime. Go Knights.
Not only are they the best coaches in the business, they're the best singers. The album actually just hit platinum. Oh, oh. What is that? My technical director, Mr. Williams, is informing me that, oh, we have another musical guest here to perform Wind Beneath Your Wing by Bette Midler. Give it up for Mr. John Byrd. Wait a minute. That's not Byrd.
You paid your due.
Oh, my.
Time after time. We've won 3 straight championships, but committed no crime. Except when Murph kills those nachos and Coach Vittorio gets in the fights. I know because Coach Gravetti has documented it all. We are the champions, my friends. And we've kept our fighting to the end, 'cause we are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions of the DPLBBA.
Okay, wait a minute. That was definitely not Byrd, and that was not Wind Beneath Your Wing. I know Wind Beneath Your Wing. I cry every time I hear it. I mean, I kind of cried a little bit that time, too. But I'm telling you, Josh Bruschuk, along with Nighty Knight and Benny the Bull, you just made the list. I still love you, though. Well, now it's my time to talk. My message to the class of 2020. Now, I have been fortunate enough to been here for 9 years. And this group of young men and women is my 6th class of student athletes that I have been fortunate enough to guide from 5th grade all the way to this virtual stage tonight. Oh, look at them. Cute little 5th graders. Look at little Eddie Castaneda. Oh. So someone asked me, you know, what are you going to remember the most about the class of 2020? You know, a couple things come to mind. You know, I love this wonderful group of young men and women because they participated in multiple sports, especially the fact that later on in their St. Pius careers, they were willing to try new sports. Usually, athletic participation decreases as a class gets older. This class was the opposite. They were the trendsetters. We are the largest program for middle school youth athletics in the Joliet Diocese, in big part to this group of young men and women. I love them not just for the championships they've won these past 4 years. And trust me, they've won a lot. I love these 28 individuals because they love St. Pius X and they love each other. You could watch a practice, you could watch a game or a meet, and you would see that love demonstrated every single time. These young men and women also worked extremely hard. They set goals for themselves, and not only did they reach them, but they crushed them. I've watched these young people grow up, and I am so excited to see them take high school head on. Whether it be in sports, band, theater, the possibilities are limitless. There are moments that stick out. The fact that you were always so willing to volunteer at our events. I mean, you would fight over who had got to work at admissions concessions. You all would always step up and sell raffle tickets during Hoops for the Troops or Blackout. Eddie did it since he was in second grade. But probably one of my favorite moments is the fact that so many of you, at least 10 of you, were willing to give up multiple hours during the summer to help Mr. Murphy and I run basketball summer camp. You took such pride in this athletic program. You took such pride in helping prepare the next generation of St. Pius X student athletes. You gave back in your own way. You wanted to make sure that the Knights coming up in the future have the same experience that you had. And I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Coaching is in your future. Now, there's other moments, too. And normally, I would just say them out loud. But you know what? Since it's a virtual ceremony, I think we should look at them. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take you to Bloomington Normal. It's October. And Marin Ferris is going to make St. Pius X school history, becoming the first ever all-state runner, the most decorated cross-country runner in school history. Well, to give it to Mr. Steve Ensley, the director of the Illinois Elementary School Association.
In 21st place for the girls, she's an eighth grader from Lombard St. Pius X. Please meet Marin Ferris.
Truly an historic moment. So historic that we need to give it a round of applause one more time. Oh, boy. Mr. Eighth Grade Blackout. The half-court shot heard around the world. Here we go. The greatest half-court shot in St. Pius history. Also the most expensive. We lost $200 that night. Oh, Eddie. Thank you for being you, Eddie. And if you've never witnessed this moment before, we're going to take you back to when the kids were in sixth grade. It's St. Pius versus St. Joseph. The sixth grade DPL championship on the line. And the Knights are down by two. Who is that? Is it Superwoman? No, it's just Al Brushchuk. It's so good, we got to watch it twice. I still get goosebumps to this day watching that shot. Now, those are three moments that you remember where you were and what you were experiencing when you saw it. We're coming near to the end of our show. I want you kids to know that I'll always remember how you left it all on the court, how much pride and Pius you had when you wore that black and gold uniform, or that tie-dye uniform, or that pink uniform. The beauty of sports is that it emulates life. You could take individuals with different personalities, different backgrounds, and different motivation, and you put them together to accomplish a common goal. There will be adversity to overcome. There'll be heartbreak, and there will be triumph. This group of young men and women were always competing for championships in every sport. And just like we're dealing with right now, with us all being at home and not being able to be with each other here at this ceremony or here at school, you have to prepare to execute and be able to deal with the consequences, good or bad. And right now you are. You're missing out on a lot right now, and I know that. And my heart goes for you. But you are Pius Strong. And you will encounter this in high school, in college, when you enter your career in the workforce. All of these things you have encountered as a result of being a St. Pius student athlete. I've watched you grow up since you were in kindergarten. You possess a sense of drive and determination, just like Katie Carney driving to the hole, that will take you very, very far. You do not settle for status quo. You want to be the absolute best. You want to leave it all on the field of competition. You put every blood, sweat, and tear into everything that you ever did here. You were the perfect role models for everyone below you, and I thank you for that. These attributes will guide you on this journey that we call life. And since you all strive to compete at the highest level, you know it's going to get harder. You know the practices will get longer. However, you know that the competition will continue to challenge you. However, you have to take it head on and not back down. You are a St. Pius Knight. Then, now, and forever. And there is no challenge that you cannot overcome. When times get tough, when it seems like nothing's going your way, when you feel sad, when you feel frustrated, I want you to remember this gym. All these moments that you've shared with each other, with your coaches, with your siblings, your parents, your aunts, your uncles, your grandparents, your friends, and with me. Kids, this is just the beginning of your journey. Oh boy, wait. What is this? Mr. Williams, what is this? This is not part of my presentation. Uh-oh. Well, let's see what it is.
Thank you, Mr. Sullivan.
Thank
you for
all you
have done
for us.
I got to restart this, folks. Technical issue. My apologies. I started crying.
Thank you, Mr. Sullivan.
Thank
you for
all you
have done for us.
Thank
you for
all the memories you have
created
for us.
Thank
you for
all you
have taught us.
Thank
you for
always
supporting us.
Once
a night.
Always
a night.
I just want to thank Mr. Sullivan for everything he's done for our school and class. He's created such an amazing program for St. Pius. I don't know what we would do without him. Not many schools get to have such an amazing person so dedicated to their program. So thank you, Mr. Sullivan, for making the past 4 years of my life so special. Thank you.
Mr. Sullivan, you're like a hurdler. You overcome any obstacle thrown at you. When you had to find a new gym for basketball, you found a gym within minutes. When you had to cancel the entire track season, you set up the eighth grade video. and podcast. When you had to cancel cross country meets, you tried to wait till the last minute. On behalf of all of the schools in the district, I thank you.
Hi, Mr. Sullivan. I just wanted to come on here and say thank you for everything that you've done. We really, really appreciate it. You have made my athletic experience at St. Pius so awesome and so memorable, and I've made so many memories that I will never forget. I'm going to miss St. Pius and the athletic program and you and all the coaches so much next year. And I'm so happy that I've had the experience to go through it and to be a part of it. It's totally a family, and I think you're doing a great job, and I wouldn't change anything about it. Thank you so much for everything, and I hope I can come back this summer to help with summer camps or coaching next seasons, anything.
Thank you for all the time and effort you put into all the sporting events. It really made them special to me. We will all miss you a lot.
Mr. Sullivan, thank you so much for everything you have done for my family, for the school, for the athletics program, and the school community as a whole. You have helped everybody so much, especially during this hard time. You have Zoomed with the eighth graders every Sunday, and I look forward to that all the time. Like, you've gone out of your way to do that. You just make everything so much, like, more fun. And thank you so much, Mr. Sullivan. See you next year.
My favorite things about Mr. Sullivan is that he's always there for us at any time.
Thank you, Mr. Sullivan, for helping me to create unforgettable memories here at St. Pius, from my first home basketball game to my last. If it wasn't for you, I would not have fallen in love with sports, and I don't know where I would be today. Thank you. Once a night, always a night.
Hi, Mr. Sullivan. Just wanted to say thank you for being my coach for the past 3 years. You've done such a great job for not only me, but everybody else that you coach. Thank you for dedicating a lot of your time to help us out. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sullivan, for everything you have ever done for us. You are so hardworking and amazing. Thank you for making all our sports memories so memorable, and thank you for doing everything in your power to make us happy. You are greatly appreciated at St. Pius, and we will miss you so, so much.
Mr. Sullivan, thank you for all that you've done for me and my grade. It's really clear how much you truly care about the students of St. Pius. Between Volley for the Cure and the Blackout, you've created many valuable memories that I'll keep with me for the rest of my life.
That was so beautiful. I love you kids. Even virtually, you're always still giving me your best. And that's what I love about you. Before I let you go, make sure you give your mom and dad a hug and a kiss tonight. For all the carpools, the practices, the games, the meets, the athletic masses, the injuries, the emails, my 40 billion text message alerts, the calendar organization, working admissions, selling concessions, working cross-country meets and track meets in the rain, the wins and the losses, the sacrifice and work they put. They work their hearts out to provide you with the opportunity to participate in sports. And most importantly, send you to this fine institution where you don't just become a well-rounded athlete, but you become a well-rounded person. To the parents of the class of 2020, I want to thank you. I received your gift today. Thank you so much for always taking care of me and for all the support over the years. Always willing to volunteer and help out where needed. The best cleanup crew in the business. In case anyone's wondering at home, the team of Bruschuk, Getz, Schaub, Carney, Gravetti, and Ferris hold the gym cleanup record for 8 minutes and 34 seconds. Thank you for always treating me with such great respect and love. But most importantly, thank you for raising such wonderful children. Eighth graders, it's been a pleasure. I want you kids to know that I love you very much. And I wish that we could be here on the stage right now in the gym. But I know that virtually we are here together as one family. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for you to go out and conquer the world and go accomplish your dreams. Whether it's Montini, Willowbrook, Glenbardice, St. Francis, or Marmion, go out and show the world what pride and pious really means. Show the world the definition of pious strong. And go out and do what a St. Pius Knight does best. I love you all. And don't be afraid to come back and visit. Because this will always, always be your home. And thank you to everyone. Hey, I'm almost done. Hey, this Reinsdorf guy, I'm telling you. I've got one more video. I will be done. You know, first he breaks up the Bulls dynasty. And now he's trying to kick me out of the United Center. One more video, I promise. Oh, boy. Well, thank you to everyone that attended. It was truly magnificent to be a part of history. So we're going to end this show with a tribute to the eighth grade class of 2020. So signing off from the house that His Highness Michael Jordan built. Ladies and gentlemen, one last time, the St. Pius X class of 2020. And one thing for all the 5th through 7th graders out there and the 4th graders, I know this has not been an ideal situation. And we don't know when things will get quite back to normal. But I want to let you know that the strength of this community is stronger than any other community. If anyone can get through this, it is us. We will be back. And we will be better than ever. Golden Black on the attack. This was truly a great day to be a knight. God bless the class of 2020. Thank you.
Heart, feel the wind in your face. It's more than a contest, it's more than a race. Cause inside you knew that one shining moment you reach for the sky. One shining moment you knew. One shining moment you were willing to try. One shining moment you knew.
Coach Williams, I'm looking for the credits, and I cannot find them. It's not the end of the world. Wait a minute. I said I was leaving. Charlie, if you can hear this, the Andy Frank security guards are putting me into custody. You need to come down here real quick and get me out of this. Thank you to everyone for an amazing ceremony and an amazing celebration of Knights Athletics. Stay safe. Stay healthy. And go Knights. God bless.